Then this attachment here is a set of graters and slicers. This one here, I'll show you up close, is a cheese grater. So you can cut it into blocks that will fit into there and just push them down and it'll grate them. Now this motor only goes at one speed, but who cares? It's still going to do it way faster than trying to do it by hand. So you slide it on the same way as the meat grinder thing went in. Screw that down. Bam. Load your cheese up. Grate it like crazy. So let's see. Tighten that down. We'll even start it up. There it goes. Like a char. Let it block the cheese. Anyway, alright, so that's that. Now, it has four more attachments that you just unscrew whatever you have on there. Like this is the cheese grater. Unscrew that. And you have, I'll show you these up close because a couple of them are really similar. So. These two here, which I gotta be careful because these blades are super sharp.
But if you look closely, they're basically the same type, just one will cut thicker slices than the other. And that's it, and they just screw on. And
that's how they work. So I'll show you real quick the other two.
This one looks like it might cut, say, Parmesan or something into those little stringy pieces of cheese that you might see sometimes on pasta, but I prefer it grated, but that's what it looks like this one will do here. And then this one looks like most likely what was used to shred the mozzarella at the pizzeria. And but I haven't, I was a little kid when all this was going on, so I'm pretty sure this is what was used, especially since it looks a little rusty and stuff. It's probably the one that got used the most. But I can clean it up, and I'm sure it'll be fine to use. So that's pretty much all these attachments. I'll put the cheese grater one back on.
It. No more knuckle busting. So if we have a big family party or something and I need to grate up, 5-10 pounds of cheese, that's what I'm getting. Now, the attachments for this are probably kind of pricey if I go to, say, the place where my dad got this attachment, which this place I looked up online was open in 1938, I believe, and is still in business here in our hometown. And this is the original box that he bought this in, probably in like 1973 or something. And it's a store fixture company. But if I go back there, I could probably just like maybe bring in this auger and show him that size. That was about half inch or so.
Maybe bring in that attachment there or something, show it to him, and I could probably buy a lot of other attachments that would work on this Integ motor. They're probably going to be a little pricey since they're, the quality that it would need to be in order to be used in a restaurant. Probably be a lot cheaper to buy something for my KitchenAid, but figure if I got this, might as well use it. I was about to go out and buy the sausage stuffers and meat grinder attachment for my KitchenAid, but I'm like,
No way. Why should I when I got this thing and the other hand cranker one? You know, I'll just use this. So that is it for this machine. I hope you liked it, and subscribe.